Hello, massage nerds. Today we're going to be doing the pathologies of the urinary system, and there's only four pathologies, so we'll get through them pretty quick today. Kidney failure, kidney stones, urinary incontinence, and urinary tract infection. So there's a few of them. I'd like to talk a little bit about the wonders of your urinary system, which is really a marvel. So you've got two kidneys, which are the size of your fist, two ureters, which look like long, like pencils. They're anywhere from 10 to 12 inches long, depending on your torso, how long your torso is. And you have one on each side. And then you have your urinary bladder and then your urethra. So those four parts make up your kidney system. And you've got nephron. You've got a million nephrons in each kidney. It sits right below, like around the lumbar area. And the right kidney is a little bit lower than the left kidney due to the fact that the liver is on this side and it's, you know, the largest organ. So it kind of, you know, pushes down just about half an inch to an inch on the right side. The kidney, right kidney, is slightly lower. And also because the right lung has three lobes compared to the left lung that only has two. So anyway, another fun fact that you know, that is good to know about the kidneys, is your kidneys filters your blood like a half a cup in 1 minute, which adds up to about 45 gallons in 1 day. Not that you have 45 gallons of blood, but it filters your blood continuously. What it does is it cleans it all out. It pulls everything out of it, and then it puts back the things that are healthy, and then eliminates, you know, the waste. So it's very important for you guys to drink enough water. You know, this maintains your blood pressure. It filters the blood, and, you know, pH balance, and you know, your heart too, that is very important for your blood pressure. You know, the antidiuretic and hormone, you know, is also produced in your kidneys. So very important to, you know, things to know about drinking water. If your urine is extremely dark, that's, you know, a sign of dehydration. If it's extremely light, there's no color, you're probably drinking too much water. And if it's kind of cloudy, there might be some medical condition going on. And the right amount of water really depends on your weight. So, and I've talked about this before, that depending on how much you weigh, let's say you weigh 120 pounds, you know, and you take that, cut it in half, and that's how many ounces of water you should be drinking. So I weigh 120, so I should be drinking 60 ounces of water every day. If you weigh 140, then you should be drinking 70 ounces of water a day. So anyway, enough about that. Let's jump into the kidney failure. And kidney failure is the inability of the kidneys to adequately perform the physiologic processes and filtering functions. So, you know, this is already, you know, serious. It's also called renal failure, and is usually not diagnosed until people's kidneys are already functioning less than 25%. So it's, you know, it goes undetected, you know, until it's sometimes too far gone. And one of the things that, you know, that cause it is obstruction of urine flow, or, you know, suddenly, you know, you have an infection, you know, even UTIs that move all the way up your ureters into your kidneys. So infections sometimes are really, you know, bad. You've got to really keep an eye on any type of infection and make sure that you're, you know, diagnosed by the doctor. And that if your client comes in with, you know, with a kidney failure, that you take precautions, because they might be frail. So depending on what stage they're on, you could probably only give them like a 2 or 3 out of 10, you know, very light pressure, you know, stay away from the, obviously from the lumbar area, the kidney area. And, you know, some of them might be well, you know, but might be okay, might be well, and you might be able to do a little bit more, you know, up to a 5 level. So just talk to your client all the time. Make sure you talk to your client before, and if they do have kidney failure or only have one kidney, Because in actuality, if you have a kidney missing, the other kidney picks up to 80% of the work. So they're good even just with one kidney. Because I have had a client that had a kidney removed and he was perfectly okay after a few months. So anyway, it just depends on the person. Make sure about that. The next is kidney stones, and these are very, very painful. It's a small hard mass that is formed in the kidneys. It's usually formed by uric acid or calcium. It's common with people that don't drink enough water, or calcium phosphate, calcium oxalate, and vitamin D. If they take a lot of vitamin D or a lot of these two calciums, it has a tendency to form some of these stones, and people that don't drink enough water. So it's very important that you drink enough water. The kidney stones are formed obviously in the kidneys, and then when they start traveling down the ureters, you know, it's very, very painful. I've heard people say that it's more painful than giving birth, even though not all giving births are painful, but people have described it as that, you know, that it's very painful, and the stone starts traveling down the ureters, you know, it's very painful, and then they pass it and the pain is gone. So if anybody, you know, is passing a kidney stone, you don't want to really work on them. You want to refer them to a doctor, especially if they might have a little bit of a fever and a lot of pain. It's better if they won't even want to come in. Trust me, if they're in that much pain, they want to be in the hospital. So anyway, just make accommodations. Wait until they're, you know, completely well before you work on anybody that's passing a kidney stone. Next is urinary incontinence, and this is UI, a loss of bladder control. And there are two types. The stress incontinence is usually due to, well, like it says, stress, like from coughing, from sneezing, from exercising, from running, from jumping. So that's stress incontinence. And then there's the urge incontinence, where you just have a constant feeling that, you know, that you know, strong sudden urge that you need to go to the bathroom. And depending on what your clients have, you know, usually what I do is, you know, they usually go void their bladder before a massage. And sometimes they have to void in between the massage, and you need to accommodate for that, have a robe for them, or, you know, make it accessible so they can get up from the table in case they do need to go. However, it doesn't normally happen if they go to the bathroom right before the massage, you know, and do not pressure the abdominal, you know, pelvic cavity, obviously. And it's uncomfortable, you know, if your client's trying to hold it till the end of the massage. You know, just take a little break. Let them get up and go in void, and that way they'll feel better. They'll be able to relax more, and so will you. So the next one is the urinary tract infection, also known as a UTI. And it's an infection of one or more of the structures of the, you know, it usually starts in the bladder. It could move up the ureters, go all the way up to the kidneys, and it's very, very dangerous. So you want to make sure that if they have a fever, you know, massage is contraindicated. If they have a fever, if they're not feeling well. I actually made a mistake way back almost 25 years ago with a person that came in and was having back pain. And I thought, oh, it's her QL. I'm going to work on her. You know, and I worked on her. And she did not have a fever at that time. But right as soon as she left, you know, she felt worse because I thought it was a muscle. And I was not aware that, you know, she was having, you know, a severe UTI, and it was already traveling up her ureters. And then shortly after that, she developed a fever. She ended up going to the hospital. So be careful. Make sure you do a good intake. And again, you just want to, you know, like I said, ask your client and have your client void before, you know, before you give them the massage, and make sure that they don't have a fever and that they don't have any other symptoms like nausea, you know, because a lot of times not being nauseous and nauseated is one of the symptoms of having a UTI, or being a little bit, you know, incoherent, you know. And yet some people walk around and they don't even have any symptoms. So make sure that you do a good client intake, and you know, you can after they've, you know, the UTI is cleared, you can give them a normal massage. There's no contraindications, you know, after they have no fever or anything like that. Just do not press the abdominal pelvic, you know, area for a while, because their bladder might be sore. Oh, another thing is, you know, you can hold up to 2 cups of water in your bladder. It expands really good. However, it's not, you know, it's not good to hold it. It's not good to hold your urine too much. So you want to make sure and, you know, void often and don't let it build up. And drink plenty of water, guys. That's very important. Drink plenty of water. Your urine should tell you, you know, by looking at it, if you're not drinking enough or if you're drinking too much, because it should be just a light, pale color. Not too dark, not too light. And that's it for the urinary tract pathologies. Until the next time, create a great day.